Okay, imagine for a moment that you are the red person on this picture, the one in 100. Now, imagine that for the past 500 years, the other 99 people have written and created nearly everything there is to know about you, your culture, your beliefs, and your history. Every newspaper, every journal article, and every television program has never had your input, and more often than not, has been negative. You are traditionally hated, and the culture around you says that's okay. But what if you could tell people who you really are and what you actually believe and practice? I've taken it upon myself to research this misrepresented and misunderstood people, this misrepresented 1%. Why? My name is Stephen Horn. My father is a Romany Gypsy, and the 1% is Britain's Gypsy population. My thesis, Traveller Theology, is, as the theology part would suggest, a study of how and what gypsies believe about God and their relationship in and with the world. This is important for two primary reasons, amongst many others. Firstly, teachers, medical professionals, local councils, service providers such as social workers, they experience challenges every day because of these misunderstood and unexplored beliefs that many gypsies have. Current theologies, such as black theology and feminist theology, they provide an insight into groups that we might not be a part of, which in turn has helped in real-world scenarios such as social and political equality issues. Perhaps a traveller theology might enable much-needed change here in the UK. Secondly, by exploring how gypsies practice religion, which is a hybrid of spirituality and Christian practices, we can begin to imagine and interpret Christian theology in new and exciting ways. Now, my research is sourced from multiple sources, including staying with families to spending time with travellers at the world-famous Appleby Horse Fair, where over 15,000 travellers and gypsies are gathered in one place, a researcher's dream come true. In addition, my own personal experience of over 35 years within the community allows for some original insights, from preparing to become a man at the age of 12, learning the ins and outs of the purity code, a specific set of rules on cleanliness, sexuality, and family honour, to understanding the peculiar rituals surrounding funerals, weddings, baptisms, and more. To, as I unfortunately experienced myself, continuing the cultural tradition of getting married at a very young age. Understanding the beliefs of Britain's oldest community and the descendants of Europe's original refugee crisis is the heart of this specific and relatively small but hopefully important research project, Traveller Theology. Thank you for listening.